A tenth difference from Germany. They are right up there, just lacking a little bit towards the end of the race. But to be right up there in the opening lap, I was really impressed by the British riders.
At the start, 14 teams set out looking to be the European champions. We had qualification, we had first round. It's now time for the finals in the men's division. For bronze, we will have France versus Germany. Before Great Britain will again return in the final looking for gold. And in the men's division, they'll be up against the all-conquering Netherlands. French team remains unchanged from the first round. Julien Vigier and Landerneau. And they're up against a German team with Spiegel, Dornbach, and Jurczyk. Remember, no Stefan Bertiker, who's at home injured. A quick turnaround, we're good to go, but there's an issue for France.
Again, another issue out the start gate. Hand went straight in the air, we'll have a restart again. All of our teams sprint finals so far, yeah.
He's been on that left-hand side of the picture that we've had every time as well.
Yeah, always that same start gate.
There's the start gate. Someone might want to wipe the boards as well underneath. Something not right. Here we go. Oi. And up straight away. And of course, we're going to go again with that happening.
Yeah. It does happen quite a lot, but we have seen it now in three finals back to back. If nothing else, it's going to mess with the heads of the people in the gold medal final.
They are sitting just to the right of the picture that you're looking at right now, waiting by the sponsors' hoardings. Of course, they're not being played out live at the minute, but cameras will be stood in front of them. For France, it's reset, restart, and exactly as Joe was talking about, that method and that particular rhythm starts again. The process needs to be performed each time. Riders are having rehearsed it. French team, for the pressure next year of having the Olympic Games, pressure and the privilege. Of course, Joe, you know what that's like.
I was going to say, pressure is a privilege. So that's a Lizzie Yarnold quote if you're a fan of winter sports. I didn't make that one up myself. I can't take credit for that. But yeah, it is, you know, we're not all lucky enough to have a home Olympic game. So for the French team, they've got that coming up. Of course, it's a lot of pressure, but also very exciting. And this is the start of that qualification period. Everybody is talking about it. All the press releases are all mentioning Paris 2024. So, of course, it's really ramping up for them. Also, and very exciting.
As we said at the start of tonight's broadcast as well, officially the road to Paris starts here in qualification terms, because these are the points, the first points available. But it does seem to get a little bit more real. And of what we've started a new year not long ago, so 2023, it's next year. It is around the corner.
I know, it is really close. I think when you say next year, psychologically, that really changes things as a rider. When we get to this summer, it'll be officially a year to go, and then things really ramp up with all your preparation, with just how you like live your life, how you make your decisions, whether you say yes to those social events or whether you stay at home and rest. All of that will just gradually start to ramp up even more.
Final place on the podium is at stake. We're away for good this time. It's France versus Germany. France in the navy, Germany in the white. Bronze medal at stake in the European Championships. And the French start this time is good. Let's see how it looks in terms of the time. The Germans are the quickest. 2/10 up after the first half a lap. And that swings back to France after lap one. So France faster with man one. Germany now have to try and recover it, but the French are building their lead.
They are on a gap there for the Germans between rider two and three. So that is a long old way for man three to go in the last lap of this race. And France still in the lead.
And extending their lead with half a lap to go, the French are riding towards the podium. Brilliantly finished. France with a 1.1 second victory, 43 seconds, 43.3, I think it might have been that. Flash before my eyes, but France certainly taking the bronze medal with a very, very good ride job.
Yeah, another solid ride by the French team. Tiny bit slower than their ride in the first round earlier. That was a 43.1, but very much in the same ballpark. But most importantly, convincing win over the Germans and a bronze medal for them to go home with.
There will be a frustrated Stefan Bürtiger sitting at home, I'm sure, watching on. Injured and unavailable for this. But Germany finishing in the top four. No disaster, but today they have been well beaten by the French to the podium.
Yeah, and the Germans will still get Olympic qualification points for coming fourth. You know, every position does matter here. So still a solid result for that team.
All the pressure on France. Privilege, as Joe was saying as well, with those Olympics next year. It becomes highly important for them. There's that gap you talked about between men two and three.
Yeah, very painful position to be in, because that last lap is a long way at the best of times. If you've not been quite on that wheel for the previous lap, it feels even longer.
The European title is up for grabs. It's Netherlands, top team in the world, until last autumn.
Yeah, they took silver at the World Championships behind an amazing team from Australia. Took the world title for the first time in 10 years for that squad. Last time was in 2012, back in Melbourne, I believe. So, huge result for the Aussies. Disappointment for the Dutch, but they are back and they mean business.
They're up against Great Britain, the challengers. Van den Berg ready to start off for the Netherlands. What can Great Britain do? They're out, they're away. But once more, we have a false start. And we'll go again.
Yeah, back straight this time. So Great Britain needing another start. Looking very relaxed though here. Having a little chat. Good to see.
They've been having those meetings and training you talked about.
So one we used to talk about.
back to the task at hand. And for the fourth final in a row, we go for a second time. Those deep breaths, that concentration, the fist bumps, and the fire in the belly. Netherlands up against Great Britain. European title is the prize. Time to count down, time to go. Netherlands on the left, Britain on the right. Three laps, fastest takes the title. Away they go, and it's good. And who is going to be good as far as the numbers are concerned? Strong starts all round, you feel here. It's Great Britain who are quicker by 3/10 in the first half a lap. And that is some distance when you're talking this level. 3/10 up still, going into the second lap. It's game on, Joe.
Yeah, 17-2 opening lap there for Great Britain. That was amazingly quick. Strong second leg here, but they have just gone behind the Dutch team, unfortunately.
It's the Harry Lavreesen effect that's done it on the second lap. Hoogland looking to finish it off. Netherlands going to be riding away to the European title here. Here they come. It's Netherlands who are the European champions. It's a 1.2 second swing. They are victorious. And the Netherlands proving that they still rule the roost. A 42.325. A top time, and that means they're just outside a second away from their own world record, which has stood for the last 3 years. Good ride for the Brits. They take silver, and I think we'll be pretty happy with how they perform throughout the day. But the Netherlands putting down a marker and showing that they still mean business. They're the European champions.
They certainly are. Very well-deserved European title. Looking forward to that World Championship battle that will be ahead of us with them against the Aussies. But super impressed with the British team, leading after the first lap. I think Alistair Fielding wins the prize for the most relaxed rider before the start, and he certainly delivered on his lap as well. I'm very impressed.
Well, he wins the prize for the fastest first lap too then.
Yeah.
Sensational stuff. And I guess in terms of Great Britain, I know we've got a big audience watching in UK. That's something to build on, isn't it?
It certainly is. So, yeah, at this stage of the Olympic qualification period, to be the quickest team over the first lap is brilliant. And to have all riders there off the line on that first rider, really glad to see that. The second and third lap, that can come with you. We've still got more time to train, more work to do in the gym. But to have that initial speed for everybody to be there, I'm really impressed with.
Great stuff from Great Britain. But for the Dutch, the European title for the fourth time in 5 years is orange. That concludes the racing for today. But we have two medal ceremonies to bring you. And there'll be a bit of Dutch national anthem singing there as well. They'll be ready for it. Job done for the Oranje. So as Joe was just saying, British team will be very happy with how things went and the fact that there's something to build on, certainly with that very fast opening lap. But it changed when Harry Lavreesen hit the front, didn't it?